Very good morning, students. As we discussed earlier regarding the preparation of HCl gas, today we will discuss the properties of HCl gas. First, the physical properties of HCl gas. It is generally colorless gas. It is pungent with choking smell. It has a sour taste, which is most important point. The density of HCl gas is 18.25. It liquefies at 10 degree centigrade and 40 atmospheric pressure and solidifies to a white solid at minus 113 degree centigrade. The boiling point of HCl gas is minus 33 degree centigrade. Now we discuss the chemical properties of HCl gas. HCl gas is neither combustible nor does it support combustion. Then what is the action on indicators? The litmus paper, what we discussed, there are three common indicators. These are the common indicators what we are discussing now: the litmus paper or solution, methyl orange, and phenolphthalein. What happens? The changes from blue litmus to red litmus when it comes in contact with HCl gas, and methyl orange changes from orange to pink. Normally it is red in color. Some authors refer as pink. Then phenolphthalein, which remains colorless, but alkaline phenolphthalein, which changes from pink to colorless. The most important, the alkaline phenolphthalein, which changes from pink to colorless. Now we discuss about the thermal dissociation. At above 500 degree centigrade, dry HCl gas, which breaks down or dissociates to hydrogen gas and chlorine gas. The reaction, now we'll discuss the reaction with ammonia. It reacts with ammonia to form dense white fumes of ammonium chloride. The equation says ammonia gas plus HCl gas, it produces ammonium chloride as solid. What do you mean by this? These two gases, when mixed, it forms solid. The dense white fumes what you are observing during the experiments, that is the crystalline solids, fine minute crystalline solids, which is the ammonium chloride. Then reaction with metals at high temperature, dry HCl gas, which reacts with HCl gas, the metals, to form metallic chlorides and liberates hydrogen gas. The simple examples what we can take: calcium with the 2 HCl gives calcium chloride plus hydrogen gas. The up arrow indicates the hydrogen gas, and 2 sodium, 2 HCl, it produces sodium chloride plus H2 gas. Similarly, zinc with HCl, it produces zinc chloride and H2 gas. Now children, we'll discuss about certain experiments. A simple experiment to show that HCl gas is heavier than air. So looking at the diagram, just you can see that HCl gas, which is kept in jar A, dry HCl gas, and dry HCl gas, which is jar A, and the second jar, which is jar B, containing air. The procedure what we will take a burning candle and place it in the jar B. This is the burning candle what we are placing, and place the jar A in an inverted position over the mouth of the jar B. Like this, we will combine, join the mouth and the jar A, which contains the dry HCl, is inverted over this jar B. Then what do you observe? The burning candle gets extinguished. Very simple, the burning candle gets extinguished because HCl gas, being heavier than air, it displaces. The HCl gas comes down and the air, which goes up to the jar A, it replaces the air, and it inferes what you are getting is HCl gas is heavier than air, because HCl gas is neither combustible nor supports combustion. That's why it put off the candle, which proves that HCl gas is heavier than air. It comes down to the jar A, jar B, and put off the candle. Okay, then the next experiment what we are getting is the fountain experiment to demonstrate the solubility of HCl gas. Normally, HCl gas is highly soluble in water. how we will prove the aim, what we are getting, taking the experiment. The aim of the experiment is HCl gas is highly soluble in water. The apparatus what we are taking, the round bottom flask with the dry HCl gas, a trough with blue litmus solution, and the syringe with water and a jet. Okay, what is the procedure what we are taking? The procedure is the round bottom flask with dry HCl is fixed inverted to the stand, fixed with a jet, and the syringe filled with water. You can see the experiment. The round bottom flask is fixed with a stand. This is the stand. It is clamped, and this is the syringe with water. Okay. So the second one, the lower end of the jet should be dipped in the trough containing blue litmus solution. This is the blue litmus solution what we are taking in the trough, and the lower end of the jet should be dipped into the blue litmus solution. The third point, the syringe is squeezed. Now the water entering the flask dissolves the entire, not exactly entire, almost the HCl gas present in the flask, which creates a partial vacuum. So what happens when you squeeze this water into this jet, into this round bottom flask? So what happens, it dissolves the HCl gas what is present inside this round bottom flask, almost it dissolves. So it creates a vacuum inside this round bottom flask. So that creates a atmospheric pressure which pulls the blue litmus through the jet. It enters through the jet, the blue litmus. So the created vacuum draws a blue litmus solution from the trough, and it sprinkles like a fountain in the flask. The color of the litmus solution, it is very interesting here. When the blue litmus enters into the flask through the jet, there will be sprinkle of this litmus solution, but the color will be red color. The color is red color. The blue color changes to red here. It will be very interesting fountain. The color of the litmus solution changes to red as blue litmus changes to red when HCl comes in contact with the blue litmus. Okay, then what do you observe? Blue litmus changes to red, showing that HCl gas is acidic in nature, producing red fountain. So you will find a red fountain in the flask. Now the inference is, at last the conclusion comes as an inference, that HCl gas is highly soluble in water and HCl gas is acidic in nature. Okay, so this is all about two simple experiments. You will get some questions based on the experiments, and what is the experiment conducted for the solubility of water, HCl gas, that is the fountain experiment. Okay, so here it proves two things, that what HCl gas is highly soluble in water and HCl gas is acidic in nature. Okay, thank you.